the pipes are calling from glen to glen and down the mountain side. The summer's gone and all the roses falling. It's high, it's high, must go. But I'll come back when summer's in the meadow, or when the valley's hushed and white with snow. And you'll be here in the sunshine. Children played games on the heather. Here
isles where they sail their wee boats on the bar. Where are they now? Some are dead, some have wandered.
Thank you. our fire and the hearth swept clean. There is no one half so happy as myself and Molly Keane. With the baby in the cradle, you could hear our mammy say, "Wouldn't you go to sleep, Alanna, till I wet your daddy's tail?" Oh, the man that I work for is a richer man than me, but somehow in this world faith we never can agree. He has big tower and mansions and castles over all, but sure I wouldn't exchange with him me little marble hall. Oh, the altar fire and the hearth swept clean, there is no one half so happy as myself and Molly Keane. With the baby in the cradle, you could hear our mammy say, "Wouldn't you go to sleep, Alanna, till I wet your daddy's tail?" I have got a little house and a tidy bit of land. You would never see a better on the side of Knocknacran. I've no piano in the corner and no pictures on the wall, but I'm somehow quite contented in me little marble hall. Oh, the altar fire and the hearth swept clean, there is no one half so happy as myself and Molly Keane. With the baby in the cradle, you could hear a mammy say, "Wouldn't you go to sleep, Alanna, till I wet your daddy's tail?" I spent with thee, dear heart, are as a string of pearls to me. I count them over, every one apart, my rosary, my rosary. Each pearl a friend, to still a heart in absence wrung. I tell each bead unto the end, and there a cross.
Beauty there, Maya.
believe that I first met her. Many an eve shall pass ere I forget her, since my young heart has been wrapped in a whirl, thinking and dreaming of my fond ever to grieve me. She has too pure a heart e'er to deceive me. Were I Tyrconnell's chief or Desmond's heir, life would be dark without London's a wonderful sight, with the people here working by day and by night. They don't sow potatoes, nor barley, nor wheat, but there's gangs of them digging for gold in the street. At least when I asked them, that's what I was told. So I just took a hand at this digging for gold. But for all that I found there, I might as well be where the mountains of Mourne sweep down to the sea. You remember young Peter O'Loughlin, of course. Well, now he is here at the head of the force. I met him today, I was crossing the Strand, and he stopped the whole street with one wave of his hand. And there we stood talking of days that are gone, while the whole population of London looked on. But for all these great powers, he's wishful like me to be back where dark morn sweeps down to the sea. There's beautiful girls here, ach, never mind, with beautiful shapes nature never designed, and lovely complexions, all roses and cream. But O'Loughlin remarked with regard to the same, that if at these roses you venture to sip, the colors might all come away on your lips. I'll wait for the wild rose that's waiting for me, where the mountains of Mourne sweep down to. Thank you. sweeps the crimson petal, now the white. Nor waves the cypress in the palace walk. Nor winks the goldfin in the porphyry font. The firefly wakens, waken thou with me. Now folds the lily all her sweetness up, and sleeps into the bosom of the lake. So fold thyself, my dearest thou, and sleep into my bosom and be lost, be lost in me. Thank you. I hear you calling me. You called me when the moon had veiled her light, before I went from you into the night. I came, do you remember, back to you for one last kiss beneath the constellations of your voice, the words that made my longing heart rejoice. You spoke, do you remember? And my heart still hears the distant music through all the years between. I hear you And so the prince came a-wooing, the prince came a-wooing, but the princess, she laughed at his wooing, and answered, another day. A year went by, and in springtime, the prince came again that way. The princess, she laughed at his wooing, and answered, another day. The princess, she laughed at his wooing, but the prince came no more that way. The years went by, and the turned her golden hair to grey. So each in a far, far country, they lived for many a day. And what was the end of their story? There's nobody now can say. Who was the princess? Why, you were, and there's no more to be said. The clock is striking 11, and children should be in bed.
True.